Hi everyone, welcome to the next session for design and drawing of reinforced concrete structures. In last class we have discussed the design of T-beam. We have calculated the, that means we have calculated the dimensions, cross sectional dimensions of the beam. We have calculated the effective span of the beam, as well as we have calculated the up to the loading conditions, the total dead load and total live load we have calculated, the total design ultimate load we didn't calculate. In today's class we will calculate the design ultimate load, shear force and bending moment values, moment of resistance, as well as area of the steel reinforcement calculation. Today we will see, okay, next in step number 3 we are having loading condition. Loading condition, the next step is total load. Okay, total load, that total load equal to total load W equal to total load W equal to, we are having total load as total dead load plus total live load. Total dead load acting on the beam, already we have calculated that value, it will be 19.05, plus total live load also acting on the beam, we have calculated the live load acting on the floor as 4 kN per meter square, 3 meter span, they are given the problem, 4 into 3, okay, 13 kN per meter is the load acting on the beam, okay, 19.05 is the total dead load and 12 kN per meter is the total live load acting on the beam, and together live load and dead load acting on the beam, W equal to total dead load and live load acting on the beam equal to 31.05 kilonewton meter, 31.05 kilonewton per meter. This is the total load acting on the beam. Next, I am calculating the designed ultimate load, or design load or ultimate load, you can write anything. Okay, I am writing here design ultimate load. Design ultimate load, the design ultimate load is nothing but W equal to total load W into partial safety factor, that means total load into partial safety factor. The total load acting on the beam is nothing but 31.05 kilonewton per meter. From limit state of collapse under flexural condition, the partial safety factor for loading standards we are taking it as 1.50. suppose it is a limit state of serviceability, then we have to take the value as 1.0. next, the total design ultimate load W equal to 31.05 into 1.50, okay, 31.05 into 1.50, we are getting this value as 46.57 kilonewton force, okay, 46.57 kilonewton force. This is the total load, total design ultimate load acting on our one of the intermediate T beam. For this total ultimate load, total design load, we should have to calculate the shear force, bending moment, limiting moment of resistance we have to calculate. After that we have to calculate the area of the steel reinforcement, okay. Next, step number 4 is nothing but step number 4, calculation of bending moment and shear force, okay. Step number 4, calculation of bending moment and shear forces, calculation of bending moment and shear forces. For this calculation of bending moment and shear forces, we are having the formulas. That formulas is nothing but ultimate moment as well as ultimate shear force. Okay, I am writing here the ultimate moment. We are having the formula as mu. Ultimate moment mu equal to W u into L effective square divided by 8. Mu u equal to W into L effective square divided by 8. This is the ultimate moment. Next, we are having the ultimate shear force. value. Next we are having the ultimate shear force value. That also I am writing here, ultimate shear force equal to ultimate shear force. That ultimate shear force we are taking it as Vu. That ultimate shear force value Vu equal to Wu into L effective divided by 2. This is the formula for ultimate moment and ultimate shear force. If you see your regular diagram type analysis, I am writing here your regular diagram. Suppose this is your T beam and this is the simply supported beam, and here these are the load acting on the beam. The load acting on the beam, it will be 46.57 kilonewton meter, 46.57 kilonewton per meter, uniformly distributed load. If you see here, this is the distance of the effective span, that is nothing but 10.45 meters. For this we have to calculate the shear force and bending moment value. If you draw the shear force and bending moment diagram for this diagram, suppose if you see here, this is your beam and this is the shear force diagram, okay, and this is the shear force diagram, and again as well as if you see here, this is your bending moment diagram, okay, this is your support and this is your support, okay, more distance. Where shear force is zero, you will get the maximum bending moment. Where maximum shear force you will get the zero bending moment. Okay, this is the shear force diagram and this is the bending moment diagram. For this is shear force and bending moment, by using these two formulas we are calculating the shear force and bending moment values. Okay, directly I am writing here bending moment mu equal to Wu into L effective square divided by 8. Okay, already Wu we have calculated value as 46.57. that means 46.57 into L effective is the effective span length that you calculated in the problem. That effective span length equal to 10.45 square divided by 8. If you calculate this, you will get the ultimate moment of the beam. That ultimate moment mu equal to Wu into L effective square divided by 8. That means 46.57 into 10.45 square divided by 8. Okay, I am getting this ultimate moment value mu as mu equal to 635.6 kilonewton meter. Okay, 635.6 kilonewton meter into 10^6, if you multiply it will be in newton per mm. Okay, next we are having the ultimate shear force. That ultimate shear force Vu equal to we are having Wu into L effective divided by 2. Okay, that is nothing but Wu as 46.57 into L effective as 10.45 meter. Okay, 10.45 meter divided by 2. If you get this, we are getting the Vu as ultimate shear force Vu as 46.57 into 10.45 divided by 2. Okay, we are getting the ultimate shear force value Vu as 243.32 kilonewton. This is the ultimate shear force acting on the beam. For this ultimate moment, shear force, we have to see whether the provided cross-sectional dimension will resist this moment, will resist this shear force or not. That we have to see. After checking the ultimate moment and ultimate shear force, the tension reinforcement we have to provide for this applied moment and for this applied shear force. Before calculating area of the steel reinforcement for the applied moment, first we have to check the limiting moment of resistance. Again, before calculating the limiting moment of resistance, we have to calculate the depth of the flange. Okay, that is next step we are having. Step number 5. That step number 5 is nothing but calculation of effective width of the flange. Okay, I am writing here. Next step we are having step number 5. Okay, step number 5, calculation of effective width of flange. Calculation of effective width of flange. Calculation of effective width of flange. That calculation of effective width of the flange, again we are calculating it from the IS 456 2000 and page number 37. From this effective width of the flange we are calculating. That effective width of the flange BF equal to L0 by 6 plus BW plus 6 DF. Okay, I am writing here that class. Okay, from IS 456, from IS 456 2000 and page number 37 and clause number 23.1.2 and from A for T beam, for T beam we are having BF equal to L0 by 6 plus BW plus 6 DF. BW plus 6 DF. This is the formula for calculation for the effective width of the flange. We are taking it from the IS 456 code book. From this, BF equal to L0 is nothing but the effective span length of the beam. The effective span length of the beam already we are calculated in the problem. That effective span length of the beam, we are having this value as 10.45 meters. 10.45 divided by 6 plus next BW width of the rib already we have calculated. That width of the rib equal nothing but 400 mm or 0.4 meters. All we are taking here in terms of meters, hence why I am substituting this value as 0.4. okay, plus 6 into DF, where DF is the depth of the flange they are given in the problem. The depth of the flange given in the problem as 150 mm. That means 6 into 0.15. if you calculate all these parameters, we will get the effective width of the flange. That effective width of the flange is nothing but L0 by 6. L0 is the effective span, 10.45 divided by 6, plus BW width of the rib is nothing but 2 by 3 times of the depth of the rib. Depth of the rib is nothing but gross depth minus width of the, neglecting the depth of the flange. Okay, plus 6 DF is the depth of the flange. I am calculating here. Okay, 10.45 divided by 6 plus 0.4 plus 6 into 0.15. okay, I am getting this effective width as 3.041. that means 3.040 meters, or in terms of mm, BF equal to 3040 mm. This is the calculation of the effective width of the flange. The depth of the flange we have calculated, the total depth of the beam we have calculated, width of the rib, gross depth of the rib we have calculated. The only not calculated cross section diameter of the T beam is width of the flange. That width of the flange again BF equal to 3040 mm. After this calculation of the width of the flange and based on the cross sectional dimensions of the depth of the rib, width of the rib, we'll assume that neutral axis lies within the flange. Based on that, we'll calculate the limiting moment of resistance. After calculation of limiting moment of resistance, based on that, we can check whether the section is either under reinforced or over reinforced. Okay, next we'll calculate the limiting moment of resistance. Before calculating the limiting moment of resistance, we are assuming that neutral axis lies within the flange. Okay, before calculating the limiting moment of resistance, we are assuming that neutral axis lies within the flange portion. Suppose if you observe here, this is your T beam. Okay, this is your T beam. What we are assuming that the neutral axis is in this portion, flange portion. that the xu value we don't know before calculating the limiting moment of resistance in previous for a single reinforced beam, double reinforced beam. Directly we have calculated the value as mu limit equal to 0.138 fck bd square, 0.148 fck bd square, 0.158 fck bd square. These are the formulas we have used, but here compressive force into lever arm distance by using we are calculating the limiting moment. While calculating the limiting moment of resistance, I am assuming that, okay, I am assuming that neutral axis is in this flange portion and the neutral axis depth I am taking it as depth of the flange, okay. Next, step number 6 equal to limiting moment of resistance. Mu limit equal to normally for singly reinforced beam, doubly reinforced beam, based on the grade of the steel, we are having the formula as 0.138 fck bd square, 0.148 fck bd square, okay. Directly here we are taking total compressive force into lever arm distance, that mu limit equal to 0.36 into fck into bf into df into d minus 0.42 into xu, where df is the depth of the flange, that we are assuming it as neutral axis depth, that means neutral axis we are lying within the flange, we know that, but calculated xu value we don't know, then we have to calculate the area of the steel reinforcement. Hence we are assuming that neutral axis is lying in the, within the flange portion, that the xu value we are taking it as df, okay. Here 0.36 fck b xu place, in instead of xu we are taking depth of the flange. Why? Because we are assuming the neutral axis lying within the flange portion, that mu limit equal to 0.36 into fck into bf into df into d minus 0.42 into xu. Xu lies within the flange, hence why df, okay. I am calculating mu limit equal to 0.36 into fck is the characteristic strength of the concrete, they are given in the problem as 20 newton per mm square, hence 20, and df is the depth of the flange, that depth of the flange they are given the problem as 150 mm, and bf is the width of the flange. Again, I am saying that we are assumed that neutral axis lies within the flange, hence why we are taking the width of the flange BF. Suppose if the neutral axis is lies within the web portion, then we have to use the limiting moment of resistance as 0.36 fck BW into DF, D minus 0.42 into DF, minus 0.446 into fck into bw into d minus df by 2. That is the formula of limiting moment of resistance when neutral axis lies within this web portion. By substituting this all these parameters bf, df and effective depth of the beam, I am getting this limiting moment of resistance of the beam as 2091.39 kN per meter. If you observe here, we are getting very lot of moment capacity, moment of resistance. Why? Because we have provided too much effective depth, we have provided flange thickness, too much effective flange, we are used the more grade of steel, hence why the limiting moment is very maximum, it occurred in the present condition for the given parameters. Again, if you see here, the calculated value applied moment mu due to loading condition, mu equal to 653.6 kilonewton meter only, whereas the limiting moment having capacity of up to three and a half times the limiting moment of capacity of this section is there. If you see here, mu is less than mu limit, hence our section is under reinforced section. In under reinforced section, concrete and steel will fail at a time simultaneously, hence we can use this, you can give this beam design to for practical construction. Suppose if mu exceeds the mu limit, then the reinforcement again we have to change, either balanced section or by providing extra reinforcement for the beam, that we have to change, okay. This is the calculation for limiting moment of resistance. After calculation of limiting moment of resistance, we have to provide the reinforcement for this applied moment. You should not provide the reinforcement for this moment. Why? Because already by providing the cross sectional dimension of the beam, we are getting this much moment. We have to provide the steel reinforcement, tension reinforcement for this beam. Hence, we have to calculate the next step as a tension reinforcement details. Okay, from step number 7, the tension reinforcement calculation for the applied moment 653.6 kilonewton per meter. For this moment, we have to provide the steel reinforcement for the beam. Okay, again, if you see here from IS 456 2000, page number 96, and annexure G in your code book IS 456, we have to calculate the ultimate moment of resistance. If you see here, we are assuming that neutral axis lies within the flange portion. Hence why MU limit, we are using this formula. Suppose neutral axis lies in the web portion, you have to use your page number 96, page number G2.2 clause, we have to use for the limiting moment of resistance calculation. Okay, for web portion lying in the flange portion, we use this formula. If neutralized lies within the web portion, we should have to use 96G2.2. From this, we have to calculate the moment of resistance. From IS 456 2000, page number 96, the moment of resistance mu equal to 0.87 into Fy into AST, 1 minus AST into Fy by divided by FCK into BD, FCK into B into D. Okay, again, if you see here, from this we have to calculate this area of the steel reinforcement. I used this formula by using the code book IS 456, page number 96, where mu is the applied moment. That applied moment mu equal to 653.6 into 10 power 6 equal to 0.87. Fy is the area of the steel reinforcement. Again, here we are having one more area of the steel into AST. We are having, I missed it here, AST into 1 minus AST into Fy divided by FCK into, where BF is the width of the flange. For singly reinforced beam, directly we'll use the width of the beam. But our T beam, we are assumed that not less than the flange. Hence, we are taking this value as BF into D, where D is the effective depth of the beam. If you use this formula, you will get your area of the steel in terms of quadratic equation. That quadratic equation equal to, by calculating all these values, directly I have written the formula here, 2.52 into AST square minus 252735 AST plus 653.6 into 10 power 6 equal to 0. You will get one quadratic equation by solving the above equation. Okay, from this we have to calculate the area of the steel required for this movement, for the moment to resist this moment. That AST required equal to 26.564 mm square. This is the calculation for area of the steel requirement. Without getting this quadratic equation, we are having one more formula. You may already used. Again, you can use this formula also. While writing in your examination, you need not to calculate area of the steel by using these two formulas. You can either use this formula or you can use either this formula, but based on your tire requirement, you can use the required area of the steel requirement. This value directly you can get the required value without getting any quadratic equation. That AST required equal to 0.5 into, this is the formula, 0.5 into FCK divided by FY into 1 minus square root of 1 minus 4.6 into MU divided by FCK BF into D square BF into D, where BF is the width of the flange, again small d is the effective depth of the beam, FCK, FY, all these parameters we know. For this particular moment, we are calculating the area of the steel requirement. This formula, if you remember, we can directly get the value of the area of the steel without getting any quadratic equation. By substituting all these values in this above equation, again I am getting this area of the steel required for the beam as 2656.4 mm square. Next, we'll assume the size of the diameter of the bar. Based on the size of the diameter of the bar, we'll provide the provided area of the steel reinforcement. Suppose if you are using the diameter of the bar as 32 mm, already we have mentioned while calculating the effective cover, based on that number of bars, the provided reinforcement we have to calculate. That provided reinforcement will calculate here. Okay, next the provided reinforcement will calculate. Okay, next we'll calculate the how many number of bars we have to provide, and what is the diameter of the bar we have to provide, that we will calculate. And if you see here, the area of the steel required for to resist the movement of 635.6 × 10⁶ kN/m movement, to resist we required area of the steel as 26.2656.4 mm². Already while calculating the effective cover of the beam, we assumed the 32 mm diameter of the bar. Based on the 32 mm diameter bar, we have to provide number of bars. I am writing here using 32 mm diameter bar. Using 32 mm dia bars. Using 32 mm diameter bars. The diameter of the size of the bar we know, total area of the steel required we know, but we don't know the number of bars. For to get this much amount of area of the steel by using 32 mm diameter of the bars, how many number of bars will be required, that we don't know, and we have to calculate. That is nothing but capital AST required equal to, that means total area of the steel required AST equal to number of bars N into area of the single reinforcement bar, that means area of the diameter of the 32 mm diameter of the bar, where N is the number of bars. That number of bars equal to number of bars N equal to number of bars N equal to area of the steel required AST required divided by area of the single diameter of the bar. This area of the single diameter of the 32 mm diameter of the AST equal to N into pi by 4 into d square, area of the diameter. Here we are using the 32 mm diameter as single bar. Pi by 4 we are having value as 0.785, and d diameter of the bar 32 square. If you get this value, we'll get the area of the single reinforcement bar AST equal to 1 into 0.785 into 32 square. I am getting area of the single bar of the diameter of 32 mm as 803.8 mm square. This is the area of the single diameter of the bar. Now I want to calculate the number of bars. That number of bars N equal to area of the steel required, that area of the steel required equal to 26.56.4 divided by area of the single diameter of the bar as 803.8. Next you will get the number of bars. 26.56.4 divided by 803.8. I am getting number of bars as 3.30. N equal to, I am taking it as 4 number of bars. I am taking the 4 number of bars. Why? Because 3.3 bars we cannot provide. Hence, I am taking the number of bars N as 4 number of bars. I am using 32 mm diameter. Next, I am writing here, provided area of the steel reinforcement in tension zone, or provided area of tension reinforcement equal to, provided area of provided area of tension reinforcement is nothing but AST provided equal to N into pi by 4 into d square. Provided area of the steel reinforcement equal to N into pi by 4 into d square. That AST provided equal to N number of bars, we are taking it as 4 number of bars, and pi by 4 into diameter of the bar, we are assuming it as 32 square. That AST provided equal to 4 into pi by 4 into 32 square. 4 into 0.785 into 32 square. I am getting this value as AST provided equal to 3215.36 mm square. This is the area of the steel provided. If you observe here, for this area of the steel reinforcement, this is the area of the steel required, and this is the provided area of the steel we are provided. And again, if you see here, I am using the 4 number of bars with 32 mm diameter. It is not again compulsory. You should must use 4 number of bars with 32 mm diameter bars. You can use 2 number of bars as 32 mm, remaining 2 number of bars as 25 mm. But the area of the steel it should be compulsory greater than the area of the steel required. Okay, here I am taking directly 4 number of bars. You can take for this required area of the steel, for this required area of the steel, for this provided area of the steel reinforcement, by taking 2 other number of diameter of the bar reinforcement also, you may can provide. This is the area of the steel provided. Okay, I am writing here use 32 mm diameter bars. Provide area of the steel reinforcement. The provide area of the steel reinforcement, provide, use not provide, provide, provide 4 number of bars of 4 number of bars of 32 mm diameter as tension reinforcement, as tension reinforcement, as well as provide 2 hanger bars in the compression zone to hold this bottom bar, to hold the stirrups. Okay, again I am writing here provide 2 number of bars of 2 number of bars of provide 2 number of bars of 20 mm dia at the compression zone, at the compression zone. Okay, we are providing 4 number of bars 32 mm diameter to resist the movement in the tension zone. We are providing again to hold the stirrups as well as to get some more strength. We are providing 2 number of bars of 20 mm diameter at the compression zone. After this, we have to calculate based on total compressive force equal total tangential force whether the provided depth of neutral axis is within the flange or not. That we have to calculate. Okay, already we are assuming that total neutral axis lies within the flange. That steps I am not writing here. Here we got the total area of the steel, we got the total values. Okay, now I am checking the whether the assumed depth of neutral axis is lies within the flange or not. I am calculating that is nothing but total compressive force equal to total tangential force. The total compressive force we are having the value as 0.36 into fck into bf into xu. Fck into bf into xu, that provide xu is within the depth of the flange or not, that I am calculating. 0.36 into fck into bf into xu. Next we are having the area of the steel as 0.87 into AIST. From this I want to calculate this depth of the neutral axis. That depth of the neutral axis xu equal to 0.87 into fy into AST divided by 0.36 into FCK into BF. FCK into BF. From this we have to calculate the XU value. That XU equal to 0.87 into FY, yield strength of the steel, 415 Newton per mm square into AST is the area of the steel provided. That area of the steel provided, how much it is, that we have to write here. That provided area of the steel reinforcement for number of bars with 32 mm diameter. Okay, I cannot write in here, I can written here. Okay, AST provided equal to how much it is, for number of bars with 32 mm diameter, 4 into 0.785 into 32 square. Okay, see, already we have calculated the provided area of the steel reinforcement equal to 3215.36 mm square. This is the AST provided. That AST provided equal to 3215.36 divided by, we are having the value as 0.36 into FCK as 20 into BF as 3040. If you calculate, you will get the XU value. But XU value I am calculating here 0.87 into 415 into 3215.36 divided by 0.36 into 20 into 3040. Okay, I am getting this XU value as 56.33 mm. Again, if you see here, XU is less than equal to DF. Hence, our assumption is right. DF, we are having the value as 150 mm. But the depth of the neutral axis lies within the flange portion only. Hence, our assumption is correct. Okay, I am writing here. Hence our assumption is correct. Suppose if the depth of the neutral axis is exceeding the depth of the flange, again the procedure from limiting moment of resistance, again we have to redesign the section. When depth of the neutral axis is exceeding the depth of the flange, again the limiting moment of resistance we have to calculate. For calculate limiting moment of resistance, whether the applied moment is less or greater, that we have to provide. After calculation, that for that particular moment, the provided tension reinforcement we have to calculate. After that, again number of bars, okay, hanger bars. After that, again total compressive force equal to total tangential force. After all these calculations, next we have to go for the check for shear. Up to now this is the step number 7 for the calculation of the area of the steel reinforcement. In next class we will calculate the check for shear and control of deflection. Okay, up to now this is the class for design of flange beam. In next class we will discuss the check for shear as well as control of deflection and reinforcement details for the flanged beam. Okay, up to now we discussed the cross section dimension of the beam, effective span of the beam, loading conditions, shear force and bending moment values. For shear force and bending moment values, we have checked the limiting moment. For limiting moment, it will be exceeding or not exceeding the applied moment we have seen. For not exceeding, the action is under reinforced. For under reinforced section, how much amount of area of the steel reinforcement is required, that we have checked. Up to now this is the class. In next class we will discuss the check for shear. Thank you.